Okay, so this is the first part of my tail sculpting tutorial. So I've already made the skeleton, which I used wire mesh and lots of super glue, and then of course some epoxy just over the base to make it a little bit stronger so I can sculpt on it easier. And I let that cure overnight. So when I first start on my tail, I usually start from the bottom and I work my way up. I find it a lot easier to do it that way and not wind up mushing parts that I don't want to. So the first part, basically what I'm doing is I'm just laying out little noodles kind of in the general shape I'm wanting for the tail. And then just depending on, you know, if it's swishing, if it's flagged in the wind like this one is, you know, if it's just a more calm tail, you know, you kind of just use the noodles accordingly to get the right shape that you want going. So I am going to start putting these on now. Forgive me, this is going to be my first time doing this on tape, so hopefully I don't block the camera too much. So I've already started laying some of these out here. You can see where I've kind of laid out the general shape I'm looking for. So we're going to put down a few more. Now for smoothing, I generally use rubbing alcohol. You can also use water as well. I guess use a mixture of both. It really just depends. The water doesn't dry as quickly as the alcohol, so sometimes it can make the epoxy a little bit more mushy. If that happens, you just kind of have to wait a little bit longer before you can go back in and work with it, which is primarily why, at least for this part, is why I use the alcohol. So... and depending on the shape of the tail, I try and do both sides at the same time, or at least try and do like the bottom half one session and then I'll do the top half because I find it easier to blend. With this one, just with how wide it actually is, if you kind of see from this angle, I don't know if you can see it right here, you can kind of see it's wide this way. And I'd be afraid I'm going to mush this side a lot more if I try to do both sides. So I'm probably going to do one and then go to the other side and then do the other half. So. Now I bought these metal tools just on Amazon. I can't remember the exact set, but I'm pretty sure you could probably find something pretty comparable. For the basic shape, I use this. It's like a flat little paddle. It's got a slight curve into it. And that's what I use to kind of map out the basic shape of it. Then I'll go in with this smaller one. Clean it off. With this smaller one, see if it's gonna focus. It's kind of like a little tiny spoon. And I'll use that to go in for detail. And then for finer details, you know, we just use the smaller tools, but going to be using this flat one to start off with. And of course, fingers always work really well. It doesn't have to be really fancy at this stage. A lot of the stuff tends to change anyway. But just to kind of give myself an idea of if I want certain areas to have more thickness than the others, I'll just start piling on the epoxy now so that it's a little bit easier. Once it gets firmer later, then it's a little bit easier to work with. Hopefully my hands aren't in the way too much. And of course, this epoxy that I'm using is actually the Magic Sculpt, which I really like. I think it holds detail really well. I've used the epoxy, the Aves Apoxie Sculpt too, and I really like that. It really just kind of depends on what works best for you. But lately, I've been using almost exclusively the Magic Sculpt. I just really like it. The first time I tried it, It took a lot of getting used to. It's got a little bit more of a learning curve because it can be a little bit more soft in the beginning, but after it firms up, I think it holds detail really nicely. So I'll probably stop at this point with adding on and just start kind of mushing in the basic shape that I'm looking for. I try and keep the tool moist with some alcohol in it. If that doesn't seem to have enough moisture on it, then I will just use a regular crappy paintbrush and kind of just brush it over the tail itself. So we'll just kind of go through here, start mushing things down, trying to combine them at least, and then you can make deeper divots later. Don't mind Harry Potter playing in the background. So you can kind of see the difference now, just with this little bit of blending, just how it gives it a little bit of a different feel. Kind of brings it a little bit more together. And this is just to kind of get the basic, like the big shapes, like big, you know, divots that are going to be in the tail, kind of push those in more. If you want certain areas to flatten, then you can kind of just go over it. Like that. Her tail is going to be kind of almost billowy, kind of very airy looking. Maybe a little bit wavy in certain parts. The waviness, I really have to wait until it's a little bit more firm for it to hold. But I can at least get the big bits in here. You just kind of like have fun and play around with the movement. It tends to change a lot when I'm sculpting from beginning to end. At this point, you can't really mess it up. It's just more of like, you know, just playing with it until you kind of get something that you like. So don't worry if it looks kind of crazy for a while. Probably gonna break this video down into a few parts just so it doesn't take forever and a year to upload, so you guys can see it easier, and hopefully this is a decent quality video once it's uploaded. After I get the basic blobbiness for that part, I'm going to actually add a little bit more. So you can see I'm kind of stacking this up really high on this side. The look that I'm kind of going for is like the top of the tail is almost kind of flipped on itself. So it's going to look a little more thick right now, but hopefully once I get the detail carved in, it should look less solemn. Sliding out here. Okay, here we go. Okay. All right. So mash that on there. So now I'm just going to go back in again, like I did before. Get those general ideas in there. I try to do the bulk of this basic shaping while the epoxy is still soft. And the reason why I do that is as it gets harder, it gets a little bit harder to like blend the little noodles together. So I found just the faster I can throw this on, kind of get the basic shape, then what I'll do is I'll wait for a few minutes, let the epoxy firm up a little bit, and then I'll go back in and I'll start carving the details. So I'll probably do that in my next video, but I'm just gonna at least finish up this part here just so you kind of get an idea. And then of course you should be able just to go right on to the next one after this. Kind of see here. This horse that I'm basing this on was a classic type of the Knabstrupper, if I'm pronouncing that right. And they tend to actually flag their tails quite a bit. So it kind of has a little bit of an Arab feel, but it's a lot heavier weight, obviously, than an Arab tail. The reference I was going by has actually a lot of hair. So so you can kind of see here, this is basically where I'm at with having it roughly blocked in. What I'll do next is I will go over with my really crappy brush. I get them like, this one actually like broke and I like threw it back together on the wrong end. But I get these at Michael's. It's like a pack of like 50 something brushes for like $8. You can't beat it. And I don't feel bad when I go through them super fast, because the epoxy after a while does tend to build up on the bristles. I found to make them last longer, I tend to rinse it off in the alcohol here. Then I'll rinse them off in water and let them dry. And that tends to save the brushes, but sometimes I forget and then they just turn into a giant hard blob that you can't do anything with. So it makes me feel less bad than wasting a really good brush. And I actually found these are pretty nice. I usually use them a lot for painting as well. Not the same ones, obviously, but this type. But anyway, so I'm going to continue brushing and then we'll come back later and carve in the detail.